Good morning. You're listening to FloorDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Haar. This morning, my guest is David Duncan, who's Senior Vice President of Marketing with Mohawk Flooring. David, how you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm well. I didn't get a chance to see you personally at NeoCon. I wanted to talk to you about what your take was on that show, but before we get into that, let's just talk briefly. First off, just as a background, you drive Mohawk's business in both the residential and commercial sectors from a marketing perspective, don't you?
That's correct, yeah. We basically do everything for Mohawk Flooring. You're exactly right.
Yeah, so you see it all, but let's stay focused on the commercial market. How are you seeing business condition in the commercial sector?
On the positive side, our business is up, you know, year over year. Mm-hmm. So we're continuing to grow. We're continuing to take share, you know, kind of align with, you know, really good customers in the commercial space. The year started out really positive. It's sort of since moderated a little bit, and it's just sort of just inching along here. So, you know, the good news is we are in a positive position. But, you know, again, we're a little cautiously optimistic just to see how the rest of the year will finish out.
Yeah, you know, we've been looking at some of the historic perspectives on this, and if you go back year over year and look at the different recessions we've seen in this country in the last 60 years or so, the sustainable recovery usually started on the residential side. So I think some of this warmth we're seeing on the commercial side, while it may sustain itself, and it's, most of it's on the replacement side of the business, I don't really think it's going to heat up until we start to see a little bit more on the residential side. Is that your take?
Yeah, that's exactly our take. And, you know, the good news there is we're starting to see, I think, you know, just in the housing market residentially, is you're seeing a little bit of that inventory that had been on the market kind of starting to dry up. Foreclosures are, you know, starting to moderate a little bit. So you're starting to see signs that the residential's improving, but you're exactly right. Residential typically always, you know, let us out of the recession.
Yeah, and you've got one of the bright stories on the residential side. You've got a product nobody else has with the Trax to Smart Strand.
Not only that, but we also have our new Smart Strand Silk product, which right. I know you had the opportunity to see as we launched it in December. As powerful as Smart Strand Serona was, Smart Strand Silk has just really taken off. So we're really pleased on the residential side of our business.
Yeah. All right, so back to NeoCon. You still have that huge space down on the third floor at the show. Let's talk a little bit about your take on what you saw at NeoCon.
As you know, Kemp, you know, I kind of started in the residential business. Commercial's a little bit newer to me. We've been in it now for a little over 4 years, and I'm always so impressed when I go to NeoCon and I actually look at not only what we do, but what everyone does in the commercial space. And it's just, there's so much sophistication, so much great design, so much great color. You know, it's really good competition. Now, I will say that I'm very, you know, proud of what our product management and product development teams did this year. I'm certainly proud of what the marketing teams did for NeoCon. I know you came into our space, and I saw you and your wife kind of come in, but right. It happened to be at a time where we were just inundated right. with customers. So we had a really good, strong showing.
You know, when you think about a company like Mohawk, your position in the market, you've got to have thousands of SKUs, and, you know, you've got different products that are focused in different sectors. You know, it's got to be difficult. But one of the things I did notice in your space this year is that you went long on a few really striking products. I mean, that product that was on the floor was called State of Mind. Very neat product. Why don't we just start out talking about that for a minute?
You know, one of the things that all of us at Mohawk have tried to do is really just simplify, simplify, simplify. And you're exactly right. I mean, we have, you know, lots of products, thousands of SKUs. Mm-hmm. We've got various types of technologies, lots of innovation. And try and, you know, it can be certainly, you know, overwhelming for a lot of customers. And what you've probably seen over the last couple of years, and what I know you saw at NeoCon this year, is if you just look at how we're trying to simplify the way we go to market, and really that started with the brand. We used to be, you know, Bigelow, Lees, Karistan. We've now really consolidated that around Mohawk. We want to be sort of known as the solution provider. So we want to take our breadth of products, the breadth of innovations, the breadth of technologies, and just try to simplify that and bring it to market in a much easier way and be that solution provider to the A&D community as well as all segments within the commercial space.
Not only was State of Mind very striking and kind of went along the lines of what we saw in several of the spaces as far as a lot of color, and with State of Mind you had a transitional color, so depending on how you installed it, it really gave the designer the type of palette that they needed to be very creative.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I mean, you know, once again, I've got to really commend our product development team, Jackie Detmar, Susan Curtis, Mike Goldman. What it really allowed at the end of the day was allows a designer to express their state of mind from a four product for a particular customer.
Okay. Well, let's step back just a little bit. I know that you had four themes at the show. Talk a little bit about your whole message.
Okay. Well, the theme of our show was state of mind. I mean, obviously, we had a great product. We thought it really related to the A&D community. And our whole theme about state of mind and what we were trying to execute at NeoCon, it was all about design curation. How do you take all of this information and sort of distill it down and curate it for the designer, simplify it for the designer? And so this year, we basically took our four main product themes, which was state of mind, power surge, play of light, and bending Earth 2, and match them up with four key themes that are going on in the marketplace. And we called it the DIY movement, generations, urban, which is a combination between rural and urban, and spiritualism. And then we invited four well-known designers to come in and actually take the trend, take the product that we created, and then actually curate it sort of for the design community. So you could see the trend, how that product fit into that trend, you know, all the way down to the colors and the patterns and so forth. So, again, it wasn't overwhelming, we didn't think, but, you know, a designer would basically come in, or a customer would come in and basically experience sort of where our heads were with the key trends, how our product sort of fit in, our design, our color, and so forth, all built around trying to simplify that for them.
I noticed one of those four, play of light, that was actually on a smart strand platform, wasn't it?
That is. Yeah, that is. We, you know, as you know, we launched three products last year in the smart strand contract, all of which are doing very well. This year, we wanted to kind of build on that success. So we launched play of light. There's three patterns. It was all modular tile, 18 colors on the smart strand contract based. Again, we continue to promote and innovate within, you know, that particular fiber system for the contract market.
As I mentioned earlier, I came in there several times, but one of the times I came in there, I've got to applaud you. You had created a lot of energy, and, you know, you want the experience of, especially these young designers, to come in. You wanted to remember that, boy, I had a lot of fun in the Mohawk space. And you had these Bumbies that were doing some kind of a character analysis or something. Talk a little bit about that for a second.
Yeah, well, you know us, Kemp. We always like to do things a little unique, and we like to create our space and make it interactive. And, you know, so everyone has fun within the showroom. I will say we also, on the marketing side, we tried to make sure that we connected it with that whole idea of state of mind. And we brought in a performing artist group out of New York City called the Bumbies.
Yeah.
And basically what they did, they would provide a fair and honest assessment of your state of mind. And they would just take a look at you and type out, you know, a couple paragraphs about your state of mind. So as you saw with the attraction, I mean, we had them in our showroom three times, 2 hours each, and literally after the first session, there was a waiting list for them to show up. So it was definitely a big hit. It connected to the whole state of mind theory and was really built on the franchise of, you know, Mohawk makes it work, you know, for our customers.
Again, like I said, it's exciting, and I'm glad to be able to get you on here to talk specifically about it, because there's a lot of energy in there. So again, I've been talking to David Duncan, who is Senior Vice President of Marketing with Mohawk Flooring, about the NeoCon 2012 show last week in Chicago. And you've been listening to Kemp Haar and FloorDaily.net.